That's actually kind of the biggest point about wind power is how unreliable it is. Like the wind, you can't count on it. For wind power, the wind has to be just right. It can't be too slow, and it can't even be too fast. It has to be just right, like Goldilocks would like, basically. So, and the other problem with it is, because it is so unreliable, you have to have these backup sources of energy running what's called spinning standby mode, which means it's like having a car in neutral, so that if the wind doesn't generate electricity like you thought, you can immediately turn those backup sources on. The problem is when they're running in spinning standby mode, they're polluting just like they normally would.
And there's a cost there, and I understand there are some other costs.
There's tons of costs. Here's a few. One cost is that wind power takes up an incredible amount of land. For example, if you wanted to generate 1,000 megawatts of electricity, a coal plant would take up about 1,700 acres. A wind power plant would take up 150,000 acres. That would be the size of Raleigh, Wilmington, and Fayetteville combined. Also, the Sierra Club once said that it's the Cuisinart of the air, and birds and bats just get massacred with these things. In Altamont Pass, California, one of the kind of notorious wind farms, about 4,000 birds a year die at that wind farm. In West Virginia, about 2,000 bats in a seven-month period got killed. And unfortunately, there's no progress being made on this problem. And the noise from the wind turbines is horrible. At least initial research shows that. There certainly are plenty of complaints about it. The research isn't absolutely clear, but what is clear is that the French Academy of Medicine basically has recommended in France that there should be at least 1 mile between wind turbines and residences.